conserving our cultural heritage is at the bottom line, I guess, for all of our activities here, and training people to be better at it than it's ever been before.
What's interesting about cultural heritage is that we want to preserve it. We want to make it as long-lived as possible, but at the same time, we want to provide access to it. So it's really a balance. So we actually allow and sometimes give an object a second life, or even a third life. But we are able to stabilize it so that people can actually see what it was like and put it into a context of its use or the period that it came from, and enjoy that historical context with the beauty that was created back then. And what's interesting about these objects, these cultural objects, be they fine art, be they work of art on paper or photograph, is that they reflect the times. They reflect the choice and decision of that artist at the time and how things were represented. It's, I guess, a testament of the period. And I think that we are able to bring that to our fellow men at this time and represent the past, I think is an exciting aspect.
History is built on the cultural material legacy in the sense that the evidence of history requires something physical. Otherwise, it's a story. That story can have a vividness that it wouldn't normally have if there is actual physical evidence of an event or a time period or an artist or a historical figure. In order to have that evidence, it has to be taken care of. It's really important to take care of our heritage so that we have a history to tell in the future.